We're recording, okay?
There is one more way you can get in there, and that's by opening the rooftop. Hallelujah! Why'd you break off? Okay, it's not supposed to open up that high. It just feels so puny. You know, a while ago I did those Sembo block sets, like the KFC and the other Starbucks. This is kind of like the same thing, but it's just glorified. It's bigger, still feels very Sembo-ish. What is up, you guys? Welcome back to Brickmeupscottie. I'm Scottie. Let's waste no time. You guys understand from the last video, I'm not in office too much, and I'm just in and out of here really quick to send out orders. But you know, I owe it to you. You guys have been amazing and very supportive of the channel. So I think you deserve a little review. Kind of have to reset up the scene here. Minimize on the lights, minimize on the cameras, and I'll try to see if I can do this new workflow for now until we get things back in order. For those of you who are overseas, please stay safe, wear your mask, always wash your hands, stay out of crowded areas, and I'm praying for all of you to be safe, and I hope you're getting your orders. We have been sending them out, but I hope that shipping hasn't been delayed or airlines, all that kind of stuff. So if you do order from our store, just be patient and we'll try to help you out as much as we can. So this is Sembo Block Starbucks coffee shop. I wish it was, but you know, due to licensing, they couldn't call it that. So it's just called a coffee shop. They don't even call it that. They just call it 601093 because it has no name. 2,095 pieces. You guys know how much of a fan I am of modulars, but this is actually really bizarre how this was built. And after building it, I thought, this actually looks kind of cool. I like the look of this. I'm looking at the monitor. I'm thinking, wow. But for those of you who have ordered from us or ordered from any other store, I feel sorry for the person who had to pack it because this thing's like on a 48 by 48 base plate. It's a little bit out of the way because it's bigger than trying to throw it into a box. This set actually does come with a USB lighting kit. It's just basically one USB with a bunch of little LED lights inside a 1x4 brick. Unfortunately, I don't have it here. So maybe in the next video, I'll show it to you guys. You know, that's what I get for moving everything around, thinking it's all together. And I'm like, oh man, I'm missing this and I'm missing this, but I still want to get this video out to you. So yeah, I did not install it while I was building it because I felt it was too messy. I love lighting the way they look at night. I don't like how they look at day because I can see all the wires hanging everywhere. But anyway, you'll get the idea. And like I said, I'll show it to you in the next video. Just look here in the front. All right, we'll start outside. Holy schmoly, the size of the space plate is absolutely humongous. And look at all these tiles. Whoa, checkered tiles. Now that's cool and all that you have all the space because look at the tiles, it looks so crazy. It looks like a black and white checkered thing going on here. You could probably play chess on this. But seriously though, if you're gonna go on a 48 by 48, you could have probably made this building even bigger and made it more of a modular style. This is not a modular thing, but it's kind of cool what it does do. So the black and white tiles do look a little bit repetitive, but I'm so glad that on the edge here, they have this pavement. I don't know how to explain this color. It's not quite brown. It's like when you have a bad day on the toilet and they have a little bit of a pattern in the center here. You got two street lights, and I noticed, I think I'm missing a yellow street lamp light there. So I just replaced it with a see-through transparent red stud. Kind of breaks it up a little bit, right? I made it look a little different and a little bit more colorful with those lights. Yeah. Okay, so on this side, you have a little bit of fabric there that Sembo does like to put on more on their sets. At least the color's nice. It's got that Starbucks kind of green, I guess you would call it. And underneath the awning, it's the windows to kind of look inside this cafe. And I actually kind of like the design of that. So you come to the corner here, which is the entrance, and it looks nice. I'll come back to the green thing on the floor. I know that looks a little bit weird. The reason for that, though, that I can't explain. But I like this entrance. It's nice and open with the windows again. You got a flower on the inside. We'll come back to that later. They also have these two big balls on the side of the door. Just like the set, these guys have balls. So the sticker on the door is a tattoo sticker. Once you put that sticker on and you peel it, there's no way it's gonna come off. So you have one shot, man. Don't screw it up. But here on the side, there's another sticker. I think that's just like a normal sticker. The menu, it's got a croissant, cake, macarons, macarons, how do you say it? So next to that sign are some chairs with umbrellas over it. There's another sticker here. This is a normal sticker. We're hiring barista. Exposure to the wider world. Okay, I don't know why they're putting a hire sign there. They probably don't even know that what that means, but that's okay. So the chairs here are not really mounted to the floor. It's a really strange design how they do this, but we'll come back to that later. Let's just kind of look briefly on the upper floor on the outside. So we come to the second floor, which is now more of a balcony, and they changed the color scheme a little bit here. It's pretty plain on the balcony part, but I do like this 3D logo again. Yeah, I like that coffee cup with the smoke coming up. You know, I'm a sucker for these 3D kind of signs, and I really like that. That was very cool. Then on this side is the interior, but I still like how everything's like a lot of windows everywhere. And that's really good, except for the back here. If I rotate the back here, you can see here on the back wall, it's like a church up here. Maybe you can transform this into your church. Just take off the coffee sign. There's a small hole there in the center, and that's where the USB wire comes out, and it looks like wires everywhere, which I don't like. And there's actually two little flowers here, yeah. The wire comes up here and it kind of holds it into place, and you can deck it out more here on the top, which is the third floor, which I actually really like. Actually brings the whole set together to me. It's very outstanding. The back wall here, or the side wall, I don't even know what part of the wall this would be called. Yeah, they kind of cheated using these panel pieces, and I just kind of wish it's more brick built or had some windows there so you had more light coming through. This is like cheating, man. So there's your tour of the outside exterior. You ready to go inside? It's really different. You saw it in my last video, but here I'm just gonna go raw, like I'm break it apart. And surprisingly, this street lamp here doesn't hit it. It's like, whoa, almost wants to hit it. Whack it. Whoa. Look at that. Oh, that's kind of dangerous. The whole thing can open up like that. That's crazy. Like once you go past the base plate though, they won't go back inside. And it feels like it's gonna break off. So man, be really careful. I wouldn't want to carry it. Oh my goodness. Yeah, don't carry it like that. Don't be me. They did not have to make the base plate this big, man. Okay, so first thing is you're gonna see before you even go in is that welcome graffiti prints. Those are prints, by the way. It's like four plates that are prints. Yeah, you're gonna have to like hammer this thing down if you wanna get it in there. But that is so bizarre. That doesn't belong here. That looks like a basketball court, which might be actually a really good idea if they do a basketball court, they can just reuse that. But why you had to have that there? That doesn't make any sense. I don't get it. Anyway, you get specialized printing. So we're gonna go, I'm gonna swing this thing around so I can see it, like that. You guys wanna see what it looks like there? Whoa. So as I mentioned with the chairs, that's why they were not mounted, so the whole thing can actually slide. So I give them credit, man. You know, I sure hope this is an original design, Sembo block. I'll give you kudos and guts for doing it like this. You don't have to copy other designers, but this is a little bit bizarre. You're close. It's interesting, right? Okay, let's just look on the inside. Okay, so we open the door and we come in on the first floor here, and it is all tiled, man. This whole thing is tiled on the first floor. Amazing. All right, it's a little bit plain. We only have two tables, some chairs, and stickers along the wall there that did not really fit. You might want to measure that and cut the sticker. You can see it kind of folds down. I tried to get it in there, but dude, that is a Starbucks logo on there. Caramel Frappuccino. So hopefully they really didn't steal from other designers, but man, they certainly stole that sticker from Starbucks. You gonna sue them for the sticker? I don't know, but I'm glad it looks official. The other sticker is just kind of like an art deco piece. And there's that flower that we saw from the outside. It is on a nice little countertop there. Oh, it also looks like I was missing a piece up here. Oh well. Oops. So after that, the figures walk on this big tile, and it has coffee beans on there. Okay, so you walk in. It is a little bit dark here. That's where the lights actually do come in handy. So it'll be like nicely lit up. But with my lights and camera, I'll make it so bright we can see what's going on in there. I actually kind of wish this was more like a modular, because it is kind of hard to get back in there. So if you want to put a figure back there, man, your hand's gonna hit everywhere. Now I'm gonna nitpick right here because the second floor is absolutely flimsy. If we push down on here, yeah, it's super flimsy right here. That's the only thing I did not like. And they probably could have put a couple of pillars there to support it, but maybe they felt like, oh, you wouldn't be able to get in there and properly play with your set. But let's see here. I love this counter along the window. That's just like a real coffee shop. There's another sticker on the back there. You don't have to stay inside the lines. Is that talking about design? Or your coffee. But at least they're using more normal stickers here. Along the back wall is the menu. Coffee plus ice cream. There's the espresso menu. You can see the prices there. Tall, grande, venti. I think these are all Starbucks advertisements. They look legit. Except for maybe that sticker there with all the juices. They don't have that kind of drinks there. They have some. Then you got all the snacks on the right. A slice of the what? I can't read it from this distance. But along the back, there's the coffee machines. You got plenty of cups, croissants, and more bottled drinks to go. And you have all the snacks here in the front counter. And another sticker there. That's just, at least that looks original. And then you have the drink sizes there, size of the cups, cash register there, $9.90. Here you can see how dark that area is compared to the other parts. Probably because there's no windows in the back of the counter. They probably could have put windows there, made a little bit more light come in. Now what's a little bit disappointing is they tiled so much here on the front, they didn't tile the second floor. It's like they gave up. They went, first floor looks perfect, second floor and third floor just like finish the set. But I kind of wish they tiled the second floor and put a little bit more effort into it. So you come up the staircase here and it's just eating area. One table on the inside, very small counter, no stickers on the side. This is really, really plain, man. I kind of wish they put a little bit more things in here. You know, maybe a trash can, some stickers that they had to, maybe a couple more cabinets along the wall or display case. You know, they always have those souvenirs, more of that. That would have been cool, but it's nice that it does have a balcony. These windows do open up. Second floor, again, they have this big fabric right there. Green fabric. And there's nothing too exciting there. No tiles, couple of chairs and tables, and that's it. I do like the edges, how they put these little 1x2s there, but if I open this up here, you can see this one kind of sticks out. So yeah, I might irritate some of you guys, but don't have to really do anything with it. It's just kind of sticking out there. Like, oh, it's not flushed down. Also, when it's closed like this, it makes the balcony a lot bigger. They extended it there on the side behind the coffee cup logo. There's nothing there. They could have put something there. See, there's more room, wasted space right there. But they do have this wall here with the flowers on top. So that's kind of pretty. Right there in the middle where it kind of splits off, you can kind of see a little bit of this orange pieces there. It's like the Sembo Club. They do this little design and I'm surprised they actually put it in this, which they didn't really have to. Before I reopen this thing up, let me just enjoy a quick cup of coffee. Hot. All right, let's continue on the second floor. Unfortunately, we can't get to this area because it's a wall right here. So you have to go up the staircase here and cross over, which they should be right next to each other. Unfortunately, the whole thing splits open, so you can't really get to it. Let's go like that, but now your hands can't get to it. However, if you want to get to this area, there's one more way you can get in there, and that's by opening this rooftop going, hallelujah, hallelujah. It's gonna hit this. Whoa, this one can't open up all the way. It's breaking off. Okay, design flaw, Sembo. So you have to actually open it. Oh, it's still hitting there. You have to, you have to actually go off the base plate to really go up like that. Oh, but there. That is one way you can get your hand in there and play with the things. Yeah, check out that dollhouse. Let's just look inside this room. It is, again, a little bit plain, but I do like the booths. They do have the flower stand. That's kind of a copy of what you saw on the first floor. And the tables are, they're kind of delicate because they're just tiles put on 1x4 bricks. There's nothing to it. But interestingly enough, the mugs have a Starbucks logo on there. I think that's the official logo. Or maybe not. Maybe it's a little different. I can't see. It's so tiny. We'll see if you can see it on the small camera. But those are printed. So yeah. How you like this rooftop? It's actually pretty good. I like both sides of it. I like the windows here. Sticker itself sucks because it's one of those tattoo ones again, but it's going across four tiles. Once you put that sticker on, it is not going to come off. So don't put it on, see what you think. If you really want to put it on, I wish you the best of luck. The back here has a little bit more of that too. There on the top, very cool. They're kind of like halfway there, like, okay, some cool design, some interesting, unique, but sometimes things don't work, like it hits right there. Okay, push that down. Finally, we come to the top roof outdoor area. It kind of stands out to me, and I do like it. I love the vines coming up here. These are rubber pieces, by the way. You do have access to there. I was kind of surprised. They actually were able to design an access into there. How do you get up there? So you go in, you buy your coffee, walk up to the second floor, hold your mug of coffee, look at the ladder and be like, okay, now you gotta climb a ladder to get up here. Once you get up here, you'll be in the peaceful world, all alone, by yourself, with a nice little bench there and a little water fountain. I like these parts, how they drip down and the pots here on the side hanging there. They probably could put a little bit more stuff here too. So overall, I'm pretty happy with it. I kind of wish they really did stick with the 32. I really think it's kind of overkill to do it this way. I guess they wanted to make sure, I don't know what they're trying to do, be like, look, we can open up and we have this crazy graffiti welcome sign that makes up for the whole thing. It shouldn't be too expensive. Now, if you're watching this video, one thing I do notice when I release my videos, a lot of you purchase from us right away, like, oh, I like the set, I wanna buy it. Check with us first because of the coronavirus that's happening. There will be a lot of delays with shipment, and smaller packages, smaller size sets seem to be okay. Bigger size ones like this, I'm not quite sure. Just follow up with us or check other sites that know that they have stock, and you know, I think you'll enjoy it. I really enjoyed this build. It's kind of nice and refreshing to have something totally, totally different. It's a little bit bizarre. It's fun. Let me put these two chairs back on. I'm gonna show you the accessories and the minifigures. So you've been seeing this thing sitting on the side wondering, does it come with this? Yes, it does. Cool. It comes with a little vehicle, a little delivery van. You can go on the road just like that. But boy, is this thing so super small. You can't even get the figure in the door. And the door design is really bad because it's just like the door hanging on this window piece. It can fall off pretty easy. Yeah. Just consider this as a bonus display thing that comes with the set. Can fit like one figure inside, that's it. Can't fit through the door. Like hanging out the door going, yee-hoo! You probably have to take off the top, put him inside, and there's only a steering wheel on the inside. There's nothing else on this thing. Not even a seat in there. Let's see if I can take it in. Yeah, there you go. That is really tiny. But at least you get a truck, and you get tons and tons of figures. Let's go through them real fast, man, because my time is up. I gotta get home, back to the family. So the set comes with 12 minifigures. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place them in different areas so you can kinda see what they look like in proportion to the set itself. I'm gonna blaze them because they look like figures that we have seen before, except for the employees, which are actually pretty okay. We'll look at the ladies first, that's the customers. Okay, so you got this lady here. She's wearing a striped button-up shirt. She looks very plain and the face looks typical we've seen before. Her lips look kinda scratched up on my one. She got a little bit of printing there in the back. Cool, all right, who's the next customer? So now we got this lady in pink. Her face looks a little bit different with by the lips here. Got a little like line going down, like a little wrinkle. She probably drank too much coffee. She looks fine, short hair, a little bit of printing there on the back, and she's ready for more coffee. So there you go, there she is. Then you got this lady here who's also kind of dressed up. Why are these ladies all dressed up? Maybe they're having a business meeting together over some coffee. Who knows? She looks fine. The hairpiece looks a little different than I've seen before. I don't remember seeing that one. Maybe I have and I just completely forgot because I'm getting old. But there she is, all happy, ready to get some coffee. Okay, now we're getting to more casual. This lady's in her overalls. That's what it's called, right? I'm not a fashion designer, man. But anyway, look, she looks happy too. She looks good. I like her. She looks fine. She's going to get some snacks with her coffee. Okay, and then you got this little girl. She probably just wants to go to the top floor, climb the ladder, play with the water fountain and have some fun, because that's what kids do. She's got a sweater on. Well, looks like a sweater. Some freckles on her cheeks. But I like her. Yeah, cool. There she is. Nice and yellow. Okay, then we come to the guys here. This guy looks very typical with that hairstyle. Yellow pants, jacket. He's the cool dude. He's gonna have some espresso. He needs it. There he is. Looks fine. Then you got this guy with the Beatles type of hair cut there. Needs a haircut, like me, with what hair I have left. White shorts, at least you have printed pockets down there. Blue colored shirt, little bit of print on the back, but there he is, looking fine. Then you got Clark Kent here. He will become Superman later, but first he needs his energy coffee drink. But it looked good, I like the belt. That's cool, it's got a little bit of a gold shine to the tie and the belt. I like the glasses, total disguise. Clark Kent, there you are. Okay, we have four more guys here. These are the employees. We'll start again with the ladies first. The Starbucks logo does not look like the Starbucks logo. I'm sorry. I can see it now a little bit better. That's pretty funny that that's printed on there. She looks good, ready to work. I like the colors, the black and the green, just like the real employees. There you go. Next female is in white with green this time. Same logo on the front there. She looks just fine. And there she is, going to serve you. Write down what coffee you need. All right, two more guys. We got this guy in the black apron. Same logo, same deal on the front. I'm really glad that at least they kind of have like exclusive minifigures with the set, you know? Different from the other figures. I think they overkilled it though by putting too many figures with the set. You really didn't need that many. You could have put like two figures, that would have been fine. All right, then we'll come to the last guy here who is in black and brown. And he's the barista. Can I have a cold brew, please? Grande. Does I have to drink black coffee? God, to cut down on my sugar. Oh, I almost forgot dimensions. Okay, I don't have my base plate here. I do have my 1x4 bricks back, which is good. But you guys already know, this is on a 48x48 base plate. Yeah, it's pretty big, man. just the actual coffee shop itself, it's around, I think, like 35 or 36. I tried to measure it for you, but you get an idea. It won't fit on a 32 by 32 base plate unless you modify it a slight bit. But they probably could have narrowed it down and be able to fit it on there and make it more like a modular. I would have been happy like that. So break out your 1x4 bricks. Here we go. Stack this here. It's around 24 bricks in height. Almost there. Maybe a little bit higher here. We're like, oh, I can still kind of fit. Yeah, you get the idea. 24 bricks in height. It's going to pass maybe 25. You want to be super safe. So you can check if this is for your city or not. You guys think it's for a city? Will it work? Just this base plate is massive, but maybe you can kind of remodify it to look like more of a road on both sides. It'll match up with your street if you're going to mix it up in your city. And I hope to build mine pretty soon for you. There you go. That's your dimensions. There it is, you guys. I went back home, grabbed the USB just to show you guys really fast what it looks like with all the dangling LED 1x4 bricks there. So this does come with a set, but I don't have a power bricks, but I do have a wall plug with USB, so I'm gonna just plug it in for you and show you very quickly. I'll put the thing there. Ooh, that's bright. Yeah, here we go. Whee! So you put it through that little hole up there, and then you just take these lights, and they'll tell you where to put them, like under here. Okay, just to show you, we put one there, and I kind of hung one more up there. You get a total of 5 lights if you're technical and into the whole temperature, white balance thing. These things are really blue and bright. Very daylight, maybe more than daylight, if that's even possible. Knock yourself out, man. But for me, I'm just not into all these dangly wires. No, thank you. That was a really fun build. It was not repetitive. Some iffy designs that you saw earlier. I love it though. It's really cool. It should be available. I hope it's still available. Go get yours or just keep replaying this video and watch it over and over so you think you have one. All right. Okay. Thanks for hanging in there. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Take care, you guys. Be safe. And let's see how much more I can come back in the office and film for you. All right. Until next time, brick me out. Ouch. So modular, better, or like this. Maybe some of you are able to mock it as a modular instead of opening and closing like this. That's too much talking, right?
Way too much talking.
So we come to the second floor, which changes, well, kind of the same of the Sembo Club that we reviewed. They have that. So you've been seeing this thing singing, that it does have a little bit of tattoo stickers. Once you put them on, you peel them, you cannot get them on. Not get them on. Whoa! Look at that. Oh, that's kind of dangerous. Just rubbed against the tiles. Scratch, 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 scratch. Okay, I won't do that to you anymore.